Hi there, Miss Barber here. This lesson is titled The Chain Rule. This is one of the most important sections of the course. Suppose we wish to find the derivative of y equals the quantity 3x to the 7 plus 2 raised to the 4. At this point, we have two options, neither of which is attractive. You can carry out the multiplication and then differentiate, or apply the product rule repeatedly. Solution 1. Let's carry out the multiplication. That is, y equals the quantity 3x to the 7 plus 2 all raised to the 4th is equal to that term multiplied to itself 4 times. And that expanded is 81x to the 28th plus 216x to the 21st plus 216x to the 14th, plus 96x to the 7th, plus 16. Now we can take the derivative. Using the power rule, we get y prime is equal to, bringing down the 28, 28 times 81, 2,268x to the power of, 28 minus 1 is 27, plus bringing down the 21, multiply it to 216. That product is 4,536, and then times x to the power of 21 minus 1 is 20. Plus, bring down the power of 14 and multiply it to 216. That product is 3,024 times x to the power of 14 minus 1 is 13. Plus, bring down the power of 7. 7 times 96 is 672 times x to the power of 7 minus 1 is 6. The derivative of 16 is 0. That was fun. We have something called the chain rule. It states, if f is differentiable at x and g is differentiable at f of x, then f composed with g is differentiable at x, and f composed with g's derivative of x is equal to the derivative of f at g of x times the derivative of g of x. This can also be written as delta y over delta x is equal to the product of delta y over delta u times delta u over delta x. Now let's apply the chain rule to solve this example again. So this is our second solution, and I think the better one. We know that y equals 3x to the 7th plus 2 raised to the 4 is a composite function, f of g of x, where f of u is u to the 4th, and u is the inside function g of x, which is equal to 3x to the 7th plus 2. Then, the derivative f prime of u is equal to, we bring the 4 down, simply use the power rule, and you get 4 times u cubed, and g prime of x is that derivative. So, bring the 7 down, 3 times 7 is 21, times x to the power of 7 minus 1 is 6. The derivative of 2 is 0, as 2 is a constant. So, f prime of g of x times g prime of x is equal to, we have the 4 something cubed, where the u was, we put back in the 3x to the 7th plus 2, and then for the g prime of x, we've got 21x to the 6th. Let's regroup. 4 times 21x to the 6th is equal to 84x to the 6th times 3 times x to the 7th plus 2 to the power of 3. If you multiply out that derivative, it comes out to 2,268x to the 27th plus 4,536x to the 20th plus 3,024x to the 13th plus 672 times x to the sixth. This is exactly the derivative we got when we first expanded and multiplied out the powers first. Example, differentiate y equals the square root of the quantity x to the fourth plus 1. When you see a square root notation and you're taking the derivative, your first reaction should be to rewrite that. So you got y equals the x to the fourth plus 1 and the square root, write it as 1/2. Now we have a easily recognizable composite function. Let's take the derivative. Y prime is equal to, bring the outside power of 1/2 down, and if you subtract 1 from the 1/2 in the power, you get minus 1/2 there. The inside function of x to the fourth plus 1 stays the same, but then you need to take the derivative of the inside function, and the derivative of x to the fourth is bring down the power, so you got 4x, 4 minus 1 is 3, and the derivative of 1 is 0. Let's regroup and simplify. We can have y prime is equal to 1/2 times 4x cubed times x to the fourth plus 1 raised to the negative 1/2. And to write this with no negative exponents, you would have y prime is equal to 4 divided by 2 is 2x cubed. And in the denominator, because the negative in the exponent lets us put it in the denominator and make it positive, we'll have the square root of x to the fourth plus 1. Example, differentiate y equals the tangent of the quotient x divided by x plus 1. We learned previously that the derivative of tangent is secant squared. Our inside function is x divided by x plus 1. So what we need to do now is multiply using the chain rule with the derivative of the inside function. So d dx of x over x plus 1. Here we're going to need to use the quotient rule, and it's okay if you need to write it every time you use it. That'll help you learn it. The quotient rule states, if y is equal to the high function divided by the low function, then the derivative y prime, I always start with the denominator, that's low squared, is low d high, that's low times the derivative of the high, minus high d low. Let's use that rule to differentiate the x over x plus 1. We have y prime is equal to secant squared of x over x plus 1. And now let's take that derivative of the quotient. I'll begin by writing the denominator x plus 1 and squaring it. Then let's apply the rule. Low, that function is x plus 1. The derivative of the high, that's the derivative of the x, that's 1, minus high, that high function is x, and the derivative of x plus 1, that's in the denominator, is 1. Let's continue. You have y prime is equal to secant squared of x over x plus 1 times, the denominator is still x plus 1, quantity squared, And in the numerator, very little changes. You get x plus 1 minus x. Let's note that this x and this x cancel out. And so when we finally clean it up, we can write the 1 over x plus 1 squared first times secant squared of x divided by x plus 1. Example, find the second derivative of 3x to the 7th plus 2 all raised to the 4. We previously found that first derivative, which was y prime is equal to 84x to the 6th times 3x to the 7th plus 2, all of that raised to the 3. This is kind of a messy looking problem. The first thing I note is that we have a product, a first function times a second function. And so your product rule says, if your function is a product of two different functions, then that derivative is the derivative of the first times the second, plus the first times the derivative of the second. Now we're just going to use that rule to find the second derivative. The second derivative would be, we would write dx of 84x to the 6th, that means take the derivative of this function, times the second function, which is 3x to the 7th plus 2, and that's raised to the 3, plus, then we write the first function, 84x to the 6th, and then we multiply the derivative of the second function, ddx, of 3x to the 7 plus 2, and that's raised to the 3. Let's take the derivatives now. The second derivative. The derivative of 84x to the 6th. Bring the 6 down and multiply it to the 84. 84 times 6 is 504. X to the power of 6 minus 1 is 5. Copy the second function. 3x to the 7th. Plus 2, all of that raised to the 3. Write the first function again. That's plus 84x to the 6th. And guess what? We're going to have to use the chain rule to take the derivative of 3x to the 7th plus 2, all raised to the 3. So to do that, we bring the 3 down. And the outside power gets raised to the 2. The inside, 3x to the 7th plus 2, never changes. And then we multiply that expression to the derivative of the inside. The derivative of 3x to the 7th, bring the 7 down, that'll be 21x to the 7 minus 1 is 6. And the derivative of 2 is 0. We'll clean this up just a little bit, but not a whole lot. So the second derivative is equal to 504x to the 5th times 3x to the 7th plus 2 raised to the 3 plus 84 times 3 times 21 is 5,292. Then we have x to the 6th times x to the 6th. That would be x to the 12th. And you still have the 3x to the 7th plus 2, but now that's raised to only 2.